Nina Simone and her revolutionary song Mississippi Goddam. Simone, formerly known as Eunice Wayman, started her career as classical pianist. This career path, however, took a 180 turn when she grew up. Because she was not allowed to study classical music at a university, because of her color, she turned to singing in clubs. From this moment on, her career as soul, R&B, jazz, and blues artist started.
Mississippi Goddam is our last tune we had some requests for. Alabama's got me so upset. Tennessee made me lose my rest. And everybody knows about Mississippi Goddam.
Especially Nina's song Mississippi Goddam was not only a key moment for Nina Simone's career, but the song also made its mark through media on American life. So, why did Simone firstly write Mississippi Goddam? Well, on the 15th of September 1963, four members of the Ku Klux Klan planted dynamite on the walls of the Baptist Church in Birmingham, Alabama. Four African American children, Cynthia Wesley, Carol Robertson, Eddie McCollins, and Denise McNair, were killed as a result of the brutal attack. While a few newspapers like the Birmingham Post-Herald, the New York Times, and the Birmingham News dedicated their headlines to the tragic event, other news platforms mainly kept silent. Nina, angry by the lack of attention the dead African American children got, wrote as a result the song Mississippi Goddam to protest against racism in the United States that led to this tragic event and against the racism that this event faced afterwards. In the documentary What Happened, Miss Simone, activist and comedian Dick Gregory explains that Mississippi Goddam was different than any other activist song.
Got my attention. Not one black man would dare say Mississippi Goddam. We all wanted to say it. She said it. Mississippi Goddam.
Well, Nina wanted to let her voice be heard and show her fellow African Americans that she was for the civil rights movement, the first dissipation against racism in America, did not have positive consequences for Miss Simone and her career. Nina's daughter, Lisa Simone Wayman Stroud, still remembers the repercussion the release of Mississippi Goddam had.
To write a song called Mississippi Goddam was revolutionary. They didn't have cursing on the radio or on television or anything. DJs refused to play it. And boxes of the 45s used to be sent back from the radio stations cracked in two.
Well, that's just the trouble. Washing the windows. Picking the cotton. We're nothing but rotten.
White Americans thus considered this song to be offensive and an attack on their being. While Simone's music used to be part of the popular culture because she wrote and sung most of her songs for a white audience, for example for the Playboy and in a Carnegie Hall, with Mississippi Goddam, Nina subverted for the first time from the dominant culture. A more positive repercussion was that Simone and her band were allowed to sing the song at the Selma March in Montgomery for 10,000 people in 1965. Unlike the bad reactions on media platforms like radio stations, the song did well in the public sphere of African American people. People praised the song and its meaning. It might even resemble the more contemporary Gun March with its Enough is Enough now in 2018. According to TV Reid, the writer of The Art of Protest, people enter movements as individuals and must continue to feel a sense of individual commitment. But at the same time, they must gain a sense of collective identity as a part of the group effort that is the defining feature of the movement. In protest, music can become the catalyzer for the creation of a collective identity. While many people in a movement can have different ideas and experiences, music can give a large group the same kind of feeling. Music can make people relate, which makes protesters feel connected with each other. In the case of Nina Simone, white Americans made her a celebrity, like the television show she went on and her white American piano teacher, that boosted the start of her career. So, for her, a celebrity in the dominant culture, show her sentiments towards subculture in the media instead of working only for the dominant culture, she includes the outcasts in the public sphere. In addition, because Simone had such a big platform, her political message not only reached the African Americans that agreed with her, but she was also able to show the people that disagreed why they should agree with her.
To get more aware of themselves and where they came from and what they are into and what is already there, just to bring it out. This is what compels me to compel them. And I will do it by whatever means necessary.
Even though the civil rights movement is well known for its usage of music, Nina Simone subverted from the stereotypical praising of freedom. Instead of preaching freedom and a better world, Simone filled her songs with anger and despair about the lives of African Americans nowadays.
Picket lines, school boycotts, they try to say it's a communist plot. All I want is equality for my sister, my brother, my people and me. Full of lies, you all gonna die and die like flies. I don't trust you anymore. You keep on saying go slow.
Because her music got such a political message from this point on, radio and television shows would no longer ask Simone for shows. The risk of her only trying to bring across a political message was too risky for the public platforms. These platforms did not want music with an extra message, they wanted music for pleasure. Mississippi Goddam, therefore, was a starting point for Simone, where her celebrity status no longer worked in favor and the public sphere started rejecting her, eventually leading to her dismissal, but creating a new collective outside the dominant collective. P. David Marshall, writer of The Meaning of the Popular Music Celebrity, explains Nina Simone's situation by saying that style represents a statement of difference as well as a statement of solidarity with a particular audience. A change in style indicates a reassertion by the performer of his or her own authenticity. Nowadays, even as a subculture, American media still represents Simone as the high priestess of soul. Not only her existence in the past, but also her revival nowadays demonstrates that she is still a celebrity. Movies like Nina with Zoe Saldana or the documentary What Happened with Miss Simone are good examples of this. Also, artists like Kanye West use Nina Simone's preaching in their own songs. On the other side of the spectrum, American political activist Angela Davis even said in the New York Times that Nina Simone is an example of racial, sexual, and gender freedom. So, Mississippi Goddam not only shaped the road of Nina Simone's career, the song also played a key role in the representation of African American people in the media. Since the creation of Mississippi Goddam, Nina's life has inspired and influenced popular culture and media even nowadays.
Nina is especially relevant today. In America, there's a rebirth of civil rights movement, and artists have a key role to play in that movement. And Nina, I think, is an icon for how an artist can inspire and keep a movement energized. And so I think she's very relevant today.